Hey, how's it going? Welcome back to ThinkView. I'm Casper. So it's been a while since the release of the Snapdragon processor, and I've already used quite a lot of them. So today I want to make a video to make it clear once and for all how good the battery on the Windows on ARM is now. And featuring in this video, we have the Surface Laptop 7 and the Vivobook S15 from Asus, both running the Snapdragon X Elite, the Acer Swift Go 14 with the Intel Core Ultra, and finally, from Apple, the 15-inch M2 MacBook Air and the 13-inch M3 MacBook Air. So the first thing I want to talk about is how ThinkView run this test. We use Python to program all the tasks that based on the regular office workload. And every application will be run automatically, like automatically open Telegram, Lock, Notion, and then use Word to do typewriting. And after that, the laptop will automatically open Microsoft Edge. I will use Facebook to update some news, open YouTube to watch some video, and have some video call through online conference platform. And the circle will loop until the battery drops to 0%. It's just like our daily task, except one thing, the laptop will run on its own without any human interactions. And from now on, this will be a new method of testing on our channel, so that you will have a general idea of how other laptops' battery perform. And whenever finishing a task, the battery level will be recorded in a log file so that I will know exactly how long and at what time the battery is totally drained. The second step I do is to set the display to 60Hz refresh rate for a fair comparison. The performance mode are also set at balance, although there are some models that even have whisper mode like the Asus, which is super power efficient in theory. However, the laptop is unstable when it's in whisper mode, so I will set everything to balance mode or standard mode. And the third step is to calibrate the screen brightness with the help of the Spyler X Elite to bring it down to 250 nits. The percentage of screen brightness on different models varies and has little to do with the true screen brightness in nits. For example, the 250 nits level on the Vivobook S15 is at 81%, the Surface Laptop 7 is at 70%, and the Acer Swift Go is 55%. And that's it. From now on, I'll use this method to calculate the laptop battery life in every single review on this channel, okay? And the result doesn't surprise me at all. The Acer Swift Go 14 running the Intel Core Ultra 7 was the first one to leave the game after 7 hours. And after 15 minutes, the Vivobook came along at a total of 7 hours and 15 minutes. Both of them are equipped with a 71-hour battery. However, because of the bigger screen on the Vivobooks with an OLED panel, it will require more power to operate. It shows us that even with the Snapdragon X Elite inside, it only have the Asus to last a bit longer in comparison to the Acer. And right after that, we had the 15-inch MacBook Air running the M2 chip, which lasted for 8 hours and 40 minutes. Alright, we have to celebrate this moment for Windows user, because now we have devices that can be on par with the MacBook in terms of battery life. The last Windows machine still on the run was the Surface Laptop 7, which also is the champion of today's competitions. The 13-inch M3 MacBook Air lasted up to 11 hours, and after 40 minutes, there goes the Surface Laptop 7 at 11 hours and 40 minutes. Outstanding! And finally, I want to have the disclaimer here. Please take this result with a grain of salt as a comparison between laptop at 250 nits of brightness. In reality, the result may vary depending on each person's usage conditions. For example, if you watch more video, the battery will last longer. However, because I don't watch videos that much, I only tune it to a moderate level. Or if you increase the screen brightness, it definitely will cost more power. But here I set it to 250 nits, which in my opinion is a most balanced level. And in fact, in an indoor environment, I only set it to 220 nits, or occasionally when I go outside, I will need more than 400. Overall, I do everything to make this as close to real life as possible. And after tuning it up and down, I think this is the most suitable for office user. But maybe in the future, I will make another version for those in graphic design. And you will know it when it's ready. And finally, if you have any further questions, please leave a comment. And thanks for watching. I'm Casper from ThinkView, and see you guys next time.